In this video, we will be demonstrating TecQuipment's largest subsonic wind tunnel, the AF1600. As you can see, this is a sizable piece of equipment, but quite within the footprint requirements of larger university laboratories. This large subsonic wind tunnel is part of a range of wind tunnels and aerodynamics experiments available from TecQuipment for teaching the fundamental principles of aerodynamics through to more advanced theory. Subsonic wind tunnels teach students the basics of lift, drag, and pitching moments. For more advanced teaching, students can learn about boundary layer and pressure distribution around models, while also being able to perform wake investigations. The large open circuit suction subsonic wind tunnel has a clear working section of 600 millimeters by 600 millimeters and is 1,250 millimeters long. The sides are removable and the front window is hinged with gas struts for the positioning of ancillaries. The floor and each side panel has mounting rings to support wind tunnel models. In addition to providing accurate results suitable for undergraduate study, it is also suitable for research projects. Let's take a look around the AF1600 wind tunnel. Air enters the wind tunnel through an aerodynamically designed effuser and contraction cone, where it travels linearly through the working section, through a grille, through what is known as the diffuser, onto the variable speed axle fan, finally passing through a silencer, and then the air enters the general atmosphere of the room. The wind tunnel comes with this separate control and instrumentation unit that houses the on and off buttons and the speed control for the air velocity in the working section. It mounts onto TecQuipment's modular instrument frame. The frame supplies electrical power to this and other instruments. Above the working section are two removable pitot tubes. The first is fixed near to the inlet of the working section that measures the airflow at any point vertically within the working section. The second is attached to this two-axis traverse, which allows movement horizontally, fore to aft, as well as vertically. This allows the taking of measurements throughout the working section. The traverse positions are measured using integrated DTI devices. The pitot-static tube pressures are displayed on the digital pressure displays in the instrument frame, allowing the observation and recording of detailed pressure readings. Electronic sensors on the included instrumentation can connect to TecQuipment's versatile data acquisition system, known as VDAS, for accurate real-time data capture, monitoring, displaying, calculating and charting of all relevant parameters on a suitable computer. A metal frame supports the wind tunnel, which includes lockable casters for easy mobility. The AF1600 is supplied in manageable sub-assemblies that are assembled on site. Items included in the AF1600S subsonic wind tunnel package are three component balance, balance angle feedback unit, dual differential pressure display unit, 32-way pressure display unit, dual axis pitot static traverse, and a versatile data acquisition system. In summary, with this wind tunnel, a wide variety of subsonic aerodynamic experiments are possible, such as flow past bluff and streamlined bodies with pressure and velocity observations in the wake, investigations into boundary layer developments, influence of aspect ratio on aerofoil performance, pressure distribution around objects under sub and supercritical flow conditions, study of the characteristics of models involving basic measurement of lift and drag forces, study of the characteristics of aerofoils involving measurements of lift, drag and pitching moments, drag force on a bluff body normal to an airflow, and flow visualization with the additional smoke generator. For more information on TecQuipment's wind tunnels, click on the link in the description below. Thank you for watching.